too fucking fast. Come on, Cammy. I still gotta teach you how to do this.
How could you be such a jerk, Ray? I'm trying. I've been sucking dick my whole life, okay?
You've been sucking mine long enough to know how I like it, so maybe this ain't for a little bit of improvement, okay? And maybe, who knows, I throw you a little something on the back end. Huh? Take care of Ray Ray. He takes care of you. Come on, get to it. We'll take your top off first. Don't give it them pouty eyes. That's what I'm talking about. You breathe in them. I ain't got much time. Damn it, I told you not to stop.
Hey, where are you coming to my house, Mom? What you want, Willie Joe? I need a hand.
That girl got to do a little bit messy. You just keep doing what you do. Pay me, bitch. An extra 20.
For what?
Interrupting my coffee break. You want the shit or not?
Doing business with an ass rate.
What you buy from somebody else in, motherfucker? Oh, wait. Ain't nobody else in Cutler County. Guess you shit out of luck. Now get the fuck out of here before I arrest you for possession.
Jesus. God damn it, Lucas. Didn't I say 20 minutes?
And at least 25. Why don't you just tell me the next time you plan on ordering up a lot lizard in the middle of a shift?
Ain't no fucking lot lizard, Lucas.
Sorry, Cammy. I didn't know it was you. Luke,
why don't you just go over there by the bushes, enjoy your coffee, and we'll finish up here.
Better yet, go back across the street and get yourself a honey bun. Get me one, too. Thanks, buddy.
Asshole. Come on, baby girl.
I'm already drunk and horny.
Oh, sorry. I have to get it turned on. I to finish up that paperwork you blew off.
I didn't blow it off. I just, you don't do that shit anyway. It's not superfluous, you know?
Well, unfortunately, it'll be really good.
Stay the whole night. I'm not trying to pretend it didn't happen. You know, I'll put on some music and I mean your place, my place. We just go.
What makes tonight special? Didn't we make a big enough mess going down that path?
We did. But the mess is already painted. I'm just saying, why don't we wallow? Just for a night, just for one night.
No, Ron, I don't. Wallow.
You don't wallow?
No.
You don't wallow?
And fraternization is against policy.
Right. Yeah, you're sleeping with each other. Do me a favor. Let's just call it what it is.
Yeah, I know it's really hard to believe that you're still my supervisory agent.
Mm-hmm.
But we still have to be able to work together.
Not until tomorrow.
Carrying on with Cammy King ain't the best idea.
Why don't you mind your own damn business? Let me worry about what I do and don't do. You're such a busybody.
Just don't want to see you make a mistake, that's all.
You know what? I want somebody to tell me about all I'm doing wrong. I'll go home to my wife.
Where are you going, Mother?
Gotta get out to pump the gas.
I'll do that. There's nothing we can say.
Evening, officers.
Evening.
You guys know the cheap hotel around here?
You guys? We're deputies, not officers.
Oh, gotcha. Sorry.
You guys must be a long way from home.
Yeah, we kind of are.
But it's good. We're getting married.
Just passing through. Just looking for somewhere quiet we can be alone together. And get a little sleep?
Very little.
Well, there's Maxie's place right up here off 51.
No, don't go there. They got roaches as big as rabbits in that fucking place. I know a great spot. About a mile up the road. That way. The truck stop on the left. A little ways past that, there's a road closed sign. Just going around that. The little road turns to dirt after about 100 yards. Going down there, there's a big old clearing. Lake. Trees on every side. Y'all probably think it's romantic. No one will bother us there?
Nah.
Might some high school kids parking.
That's perfect. Let's do that.
Okay. Well, thanks for the suggestion. You sent him for the holler? You know what goes on there nowadays?
I don't know shit about what goes on there. Except what's always going on there. I swear to God, Lucas, you turned into such a fucking pussy.
Yeah. I be there in 10.
Jerry's got the new batch ready.
I don't give a shit and I wish you wouldn't involve me in it.
Well, you're in it up to your fucking eyeballs, Lucas. So get used to it.
Looks like it.
That's pretty terrible.
Really creepy.
Don't judge. He said it's gonna be romantic.
Did you see that kid?
Why would he be out here so late?
He's good.
Down here.
I think I understand the difference.
This is really beautiful. Maybe get a blanket, go outside.
Backseat. Supposed to be fighting crime, but causing it to be.
You gotta be kidding me with that shit. Fighting crime? Who are you, fucking Batman? Don't be a child.
Okay, well, phraseology was stupid, but the point holds.
Phraseology? Where do you get this shit?
Just trying to let you know where I stand. I don't want to go down from you dealing shit. It's not on me.
Now you just watch, right? You been in a courtroom lately? What they call watching. Here's a big word for you. A compass. Keep an eye out for the law, okay? Oh, wait a minute, dipshit. We are the fucking law. Quit your fucking blanket.
She's up.
Why'd you have to make a bunch of racket getting dressed?
She's fine. Why is she wasting when she wants to, racket or not? Look, I gotta get to work. Principal Markey's already been on me once about Max not being late.
I'll never talk to that douchebag. He thinks he's God's gift.
Oh, honey. All I'm saying is working graveyard doesn't mean you don't still have responsibilities at home.
Responsibilities?
You wanna sleep in? Find some money for a babysitter for Tilly.
Why can't your mama take her?
Mama takes Uncle Webb to dialysis on Thursdays, you know that.
Well, let Tilly go with him.
Gosh, you are ridiculous sometimes. I gotta go. You got her or not?
Look, I don't know why you're in a foul mood. Because all I've been doing is working all night like a dog to provide for this family. And I deserve just a little bit of consideration.
I'm sure last night was tiring for you. What do you want me to do about it? Huh? You want a little back rub or something?
I really would like a back rub, but you ain't gonna give me one. So I think it's pretty cruel for you to taunt me with it.
What if I told you about Gus in front of the kids?
It was under my breath. Are you still jumping?
Are you gonna answer your phone?
What? Hey, Donna. Really? I'll be right there. Call your sister.
Hey, I used your toothbrush.
What?
I used your toothbrush.
It's all over the toilets. What time is it?
You gotta get up. We're going to Mississippi.
What? What's in Mississippi?
Triple homicide. One of the Vicks was a congressman's daughter.
I'm supposed to have Jacob today.
Next Thursday?
We were gonna go to a ball game.
I was supposed to have him at the weekend.
So that's what last night was about?
No. Maybe. I don't know.
Well, you gotta get up.
Hey, shoot it, kids. Hey, Chief.
You know what? I like it when you do that.
What's that?
Sexually harass me.
Hell, that's just how I say good morning.
You're a big boy, Ray. Use your words.
Shit's hit the fan, eh?
You might want to pick that cigarette butt up. This is a crime scene. Hey, Ray. I am sorry about Cammy.
I barely knew her.
I really don't want to go to Mississippi today. Like home, but I should spend some time with myself.
Vaughn, you got an opportunity to work point in the murder of a U.S. congressman's daughter. Cahill's giving you a huge vote of confidence here. It's his way of acknowledging that you're okay.
What if I'm not okay? Hmm? What if I'm not okay?
You're a good agent. End of story. Baby, I know how important Jacob is to you. But you gotta think big picture.
Big picture, man.
Are you serious? Bringing her here?
We're on our way to the airport. What do you want her to do?
I don't want you to do anything.
Jen, I was really looking forward to this. And I really appreciate you letting me. I'm just saying, I want to spend more time with him in this case.
Is more important than your son.
No, I didn't say that, did I? Please, Jen. I'm sorry. Can I see him?
Jacob?
Hey. How you doing, old buddy?
So you're not gonna see a ball game?
No, I can't. I can't today. But I tell you what. I really want to hang out with you. But some bad stuff happened and they need me.
So you're the only one who can get the bad guys?
No, it's just, Daddy needs to go to work. But I'll tell you what, okay? The second I get back, I will call you. I will go see you again together. How's that sound?
I'll have to ask Mom.
Yeah. I'll call you, okay?
Okay. You guys go to bed at 8:30.
I'll call before 8:30. Give me a hug. Be good for your mom, okay?
I'll take this real seriously, okay? I'm gonna see the family.
Ray? What in the Sam holy fuck happened here last night? Don't give me that shit-eating grin. Do you know what happened here? Hey, dumbass. Look at me. I'm the one talking to you.
Right.
Shut the fuck up, Lucas.
Look, I don't know what everybody's angsting about, but I can say with some certainty that I didn't have anything to do with this.
She was found with drugs. Methamphetamine. You don't know nothing about that.
Meth? How can you guys?
Don't be an asshole, eh? The little girl in that SUV, the one with the Illinois plate, she is the daughter of a United States congressman from the state of fucking Illinois. Do you even know where Illinois is? That means the FBI has been called in. And that means they're going to be all over Cutler County. The federal fucking government. That means you are going to pull your dick out of the county, ass, and put your little sideline business on hold until we figure out what happened here. And if I find out that you had anything to do with it, I will kill you myself.
Okay. Okay. First, second, I don't think you could kill me, not to verify Daddy is. And third, I didn't have anything to do with killing anybody. I didn't have anything to do with any of this.
I hope you're telling the truth, Ray. I swear, I hope you're telling the truth. I'm trying to mind my own business and get to my retirement and do a little bit of fishing. And the last thing I need right now is this kind of bullshit. Now, you excuse me. I gotta go meet and greet with the FB fucking I. Welcome to Mississippi.
Special Agent Von Killinger, FBI. Criminal Division.
This is Special Agent DeSoto.
How do you do, ma'am?
And Jordy Mills, our resident scraper and swabber.
Scraper and swabber.
Jordan's our forensic pathologist. She'll be working alongside your ME.
ME?
Medical examiner.
Medical examiner.
Coroner?
Right, right. No, it's usually just it's a one-man job is all. So it's just the three of you?
Well, just the three of us here, yes. But our tech guys are setting up shop at your office.
In my office. All right. Well, that sounds serious. Hope this don't take too long.
Right. What you got here, Sheriff?
Well, we got a hell of a damn mess is what we got. We got three dead kids, and one of them is a little girl with her face bashed in. I don't know how that happened. Can't believe it's Cammy. And the kids... Why'd you send them down here? I mean, you must feel.
First time me and Trisha fucked was right here by this lake. Bet him a pickup. We were 16 years old. This place was sweet. It was all there was.
Why are you feeling nostalgic?
I don't even know what the fuck that means. Speak fucking English when you talk to me, Lucas. I'm just saying. God damn it, if there weren't so many people around, I'd kick your fucking ass right here.
And I'd tell Daddy everything I remember about last night. No response? That's uncommon for you.
You just reminded me of something I gotta take care of. Don't make plans for when we get home.
Cribs. Said he come down here fishing this morning.
What is he fishing for?
Yeah, let's make sure he doesn't get away before somebody on our team talks to him.
Yeah, well, as you can see, we're already doing that.
There's an awful lot of people on the wrong side of the tip. Can we fix that, please?
What exactly would you like me to do about that?
I'd like you to minimize the contamination already done to the crime scene. Try and make sure there isn't any more. Can you do that?
Why don't we just take a look at the bodies?
I'll leave that with you then, Sheriff.
These guys look like pricks.
God. It's hot as balls down here. Sweating my ass off. My head is killing me.
Maybe you shouldn't drink so much.
Maybe I should drink some more.
Can we get everybody that doesn't have to be here just the hell out of the way?
Somebody will come take this dog.
That there is the local girl. Agents. This is Deputy Ray Everett. Hi.
Hi, Sarah.
Well, you must not shake hands.
Excuse me.
I'm Lucas, Deputy McKinney. Welcome to our town.
Lucas.
All right, let's take a look. Jeez. Well, I think we can rule out accidents. This was personal.
I saw this crushed. Maybe her jaw's broken, too. She was hit with something harder than a fist.
Makeout session gone south. No pun intended. Were the others beaten like this?
Nope. Just shot.
Wrong place, wrong time.
Who was she?
High school girl. Kind of a cheerleader with a questionable reputation type.
Questionable how?
Well,
DeSoto?
I wonder if the local meth dealer knows anything.
Let's get a talk screen as soon as possible, okay?
Yeah.
There was more in the car, along with some paraphernalia. We left it pretty near the way we found it, though. It's not unusual that some shady stuff goes on down here.
All right. Shady stuff like what?
Listen, the congressman's supposed to be on his way to ID his daughter's body. And we were told to clean her up. So if y'all want to see the bodies on the scene, you probably want to hurry along.
Told by who?
The congressman's office.
Oh. Because last I checked, the congressman wasn't on the FBI payroll.
Still, if you don't mind stepping it up.
Jordy?
Yeah, we need to do that right now.
Appreciate it.
Graveyard too, remember?
Mm-hmm. You're a fucking idiot, Lucas.
But let justice roll down like waters. And righteousness like a mighty stream.
Say it's the worst pain a human being can feel, losing a child. Shame it happened here.
You want to talk to the congressman?
Not really. But I guess we should. Just out of college. Had been accepted to Yale Law. I thought she was going to derail her career.
Her career? She was 22 years old, Will. Really?
I mean, I just wanted her to wait. That boy, I didn't think he was worthy of her. I guess I didn't think she would openly define me.
I'm sure you did what you thought was best for her.
Did I? Maybe it is my fault. Could I be somehow responsible?
Maybe. Maybe not.
What did you say?
Parents always think they know what's best for their kids. Sometimes they do, sometimes they don't.
You're a fucking asshole.
Why Mississippi? It's a long way from home.
I think that was the point.
What does that mean, Lily?
It means exactly what it sounds like, Will. Where's your nearest restroom?
It's back that way. Around the corner to the right.
I'll see to it you get whatever resources you need to find the person who did this. It's imperative you find the person who did this. Agent, are you listening to me? At this time, I'm prepared to make a brief statement.
What do you expect? He's a public figure. Put himself in that world.
He's a father who just lost his daughter. You could have a little understanding.
I understand. Where are we going?
Start with the King Girl's parents, the high school?
No more parents today. I need to make a pit stop. Okay, give me 2 minutes.
Got anything to drink?
You got ass. You ever near anything you can imagine on that back wall?
Yeah, no, I meant alcohol.
Nah, we don't sell that devil's liquor here. Cutler's dry as a bone. Thank you, Jesus. You're gonna have to cross the line over into green.
Right, how far is that?
Far enough away from us righteous folk.
Are you fucking with me?
What are we doing here? Why'd you make me come, Ray? I got a date with Dinah tonight. I need to get home.
You know, this is a hell of a lot more important than your little piece of ass, aight? Now you with me, you gonna try to fuck me on this. Go on and tell me one way or another so I can make arrangements.
I'm with you, Ray, okay? Shit.
Now, Jolene, you stop smoking so much of this shit, you can beat somebody.
What do you think I'm gonna be?
You can have it for me.
What the hell you doing busting up in my house?
Jolene! Didn't realize you had a thing with dark meat.
Fuck you, Ray.
You might want to put your pants on and take your leave.
Come on now.
Wait, I ain't even got a vehicle yet.
Then step the fuck out on the front porch. Jesus Christ.
Right. What'd I ask you outside? You won't change your answer?
Nope. Heard about what happened to Cammy and that congressman's daughter last night?
I might have heard something. It's a worth two. You know, maybe you want to throw me a little something, something in exchange for my silence.
I can be both.
Ray! God damn it! Fuck it up, big time, boy! Oh! Please get out! What do you want? What do you want?
I'll just be you, motherfucker!
You made your point!
Get the fuck off me, Lucas! tell anybody you saw me with Kimmy last night? Did you tell anybody you saw me with Kimmy last night? Say the fucking words!
No!
Do it again!
No, please! No! Fuck no! I asked nobody but Jolene. I saw my phone call.
You can tell Jolene?
I can't remember.
You listen to me. And you listen to me good now. I ain't giving you shit, and I sure as shit ain't gonna be beholden to you. But I swear to God, if you open that black-ass mouth of yours to anybody, anybody about what you saw last night, I'm gonna come back here and lay more permanent hurt on you. You feel me?
Do you feel me, motherfucker?
The pain!
For real, I swear.
You better. Get the fuck out of here. Dumbass motherfucker.
You really ought to find yourself a more upstanding individual to hang around with. Right, what? Wayne's gotta do what he's gotta do to protect his interests.
Hey, Ray. You don't think maybe you could give me a little something? You know, for more trouble?
I can be a nice guy. You just keep looking out the window, Lucas.
And these kinds of losses, tragedies really, can be devastating to an entire community, especially a small, close-knit town like ours. And the high school in particular feels the brunt most of all. Now, we had a young man die in an automobile accident last year. I think these kids, they're too young to come to terms with the idea of mortality, you know? So when they're forced to reckon with it, it shakes them up pretty hard. Now, these girls, they knew Cammy better than anybody. I'd recommend starting with them.
Oh, thank you. But I was thinking to talk a little more with you first. I'm pretty sure you know these kids pretty well.
Oh, sure, that's fair. Why don't we take it into my office?
Great.
Football team's still practicing. Cheerleaders aren't. Priorities, though.
Well, we should get this over with. We got a football game this weekend, and it's fallen on me to decide whether we should have extracurricular activities with all this mess.
Sure, I just have a few more questions.
Football's a big deal down here.
Right. I'm going to stay and talk to the kids, okay?
Great. Right this way. Like I've said, Cammy had her share of problems. She didn't always run with the good crowd, if you know what I mean. But in general, she was a pistol, had a lot of spunk, and she was well-liked.
So you had a relationship with her?
Now, what do you mean by that?
Well, judging from the way you talk about her, you clearly took an interest in her.
I take an interest in all my students.
Was she dating anyone?
Well, she was a free-spirited girl.
Hey, mister, you notice it's a dry county. And you're on the grounds of a public high school. Shame on you, sir.
It's empty.
Ain't that always the way? Bottle's always bone dry just when you need it most. Hey, man, I'm just messing with you. I got one of my own. Does that make us kindred spirits? Of course, I'm a bourbon man myself. You want it?
No, thank you.
Yeah, like my granddaddy always said, see no evil, hear no evil. That's my grandson out there playing quarterback. You know, I love to come out here and watch him play. He has what the scouts call football intelligence. That's the ability to be able to see things before they materialize on the field. It's very important of a quarterback. You know what I think? I think you're the incarnation of high-level law enforcement. Sent here to save us from ourselves amongst all this tragedy.
I don't know about that. I'm just here to find out what happened to three young kids that should be alive right now.
Indeed, sir. John Dawson. Folks down here call me Big John. Reckon I don't even know why. Please make your acquaintance. You are.
Vaughn, Dillinger. I'm with the Bureau.
FBI. I'm impressed.
So tell me, John, what do you do around here?
Well, that's a loaded question, sir.
I believe most recently she was spending quite a bit of time with our quarterback, Tad Dawson.
Okay. Well, if we have any more questions, we'll let you know. And please give me a call if there's anything else you can think of that might be relevant.
I surely will.
Just out of curiosity, do you actually use those paddles on students? Or are they more for show?
For show? No. I certainly do use them when necessary. I have developed a reputation for being a strict disciplinarian over the years. The ones I'm most proud of are ones given to me by former students who knew good and well how hard I could swim.
Well, I'm sure you'll make the right decision about the game.
Now, baseball gets all the credit for being a thinking man's sport. And people think that football is all about natural ability, speed, and strength. But to be a great quarterback, you got to think like a chess master. And you got to be able to move quickly in the heat of battle. You ever play a sport?
Baseball.
Was that your colleague over there? Well, no, she is a beautiful woman. You're a lucky man.
I certainly am. Hey, sir. This is John.
John Dawson, country lawyer. Pleasure to meet you.
Dawson, you wouldn't happen to be related to Tad Dawson, the quarterback?
Yes, ma'am, I am.
Well, hey, John. I was just on my way out.
What the hell's all this crap I'm hearing about you thinking about canceling the football game? And you better be able to answer this. What the hell are two FBI agents doing around here asking questions about my grandson?
Agents came by the school this afternoon.
Who's the agent, Daddy?
Somebody who ain't from here.
What? It's Tetrazzini.
Yeah, well, I guess I ain't in the mood for Tetrazzini.
Got any idea who did it?
No.
Surely they must have some theory or something. Must be on top of you since you were working last night, huh?
What makes you say that? Sorry. Yeah. Well, I'm eating right now. No, I meant no disrespect. Okay, I got you. I'll be right there.
Red, what now?
Put a paper towel on a plate and put it in the oven. It won't be long.
Where's Daddy going?
I'm not dressed.
Yeah. Most times I call that positive. But, I don't know, just... I want to do something. I don't know, I feel kind of restless, you know?
It's been a really long day. What do you want to do?
Cross the line.
Drinking and being pissed off.
Some people just want to live. Like people who don't give a shit about that. I just want to live myself.
I feel responsible.
You're responsible because I lost my shit with Jenna that night? Well, I married the wrong woman in the first place. Not that I absolutely fucking love to drink, not beer.
You know what I'm trying to say. Responsible because of us.
You know what? You are responsible. You're responsible for keeping me from losing that job. Probably for keeping me alive.
You're so dramatic.
No. I'm just saying, if it wasn't for you, then... Fuck!
What?
I said I'd call Jacob before it's bedtime. I'll be back.
What? Do you want another beer? Two more? Hey, Agent DeSoto, right?
Sarah.
I'm Donna, the dog girl. The canine patrol unit. You know, with the sheriff's department.
Hey, Jenna. Is he up? No. No.
Yeah, I saw you at the scene with the German Shepherd.
Yeah, I love dogs. Because
she's so much not like people.
God damn it, Jenna. The time just slipped away from me. I was traveling, then I was working. No, it's not an excuse!
So this is the local hangout?
Yeah, you like it? My daddy owns it. The other folks in Cutler, they were scandalized to be so close for a hot minute there. But 30 years running this side of the line. That's something, ain't it?
I guess it is.
Okay, it's an excuse, but it's the truth. I'm just trying to tell you what happened. Is that him? Is that him talking in the background?
I guess I'll be seeing you again. Right in the
Hey, pretty lady. Can I buy you a drink?
No, thank you.
You must not be from around here, are you?
I should not.
I'm sorry. I'm fucking sorry! How many times do you want me to say it?
You're being a little rude right now. It'll take some kind of rude folks around here. Ain't nothing wrong with buying a drink for a good-looking woman.
It was not my intention to be rude. I'm with somebody, okay? Have a nice night.
Jenna! Jenna!
What the hell did I do to piss you off? Ain't like I asked you to take you around back and fuck you sideways.
I don't think you really want to do this.
Where was it?
I'm going to tell you a secret.
I like secrets.
It'll be better tomorrow. It'll be better tomorrow.
I will fucking kill you, bitch.
You're threatening a federal agent.
This bitch says she knows how to rip a man's balls off. You don't talk to a man that way.
What the fuck is going on here?
I was just stating a fact.
Why don't you mind your own goddamn business? I hesitate to hit a woman, but I take pleasure in whooping your ass.
Try me. I kind of feel like I need to beat on something like that.
Billy, come on, man. These are FBI agents.
What matters to me if they fucking Pope John Paul?
Vaughn, I got this.
Are you Catholic?
What?
Well, Pope John Paul's not the Pope anymore. He's like two popes back. And he's dead. He was canonized in very short order. Which you probably know if you were Catholic, although I'm not sure because you're neither very smart nor observant. But you're probably not because... And this is a generalization, so forgive me, but I find that close-minded, hillbilly, redneck motherfuckers like yourself tend to proclaim some radicalized Protestant strand of Christianity. But you know, if there is a God, you should tread very, very lightly.
Hey, Vaughn, let's go.
What the hell did you just say?
You hard of hearing, asshole?
Vaughn, drop it. Let's get out of here.
That's right, you little pussy. Hide behind the woman in big words of yours. You can last all around here.
Jesus, really?
I got an idea. Why don't you rear back and hit me as hard as you can, and we'll see where we get from there. Come on, do it. Hit me.
Hit me! That's enough, Billy!
Let him go.
Look, Agent, he's sorry. He's just got a big mouth, okay?
I said let him go.
Do what he says, Lucas. He's a federal agent.
Oh. I'll at least take this outside. You hear me?
My pleasure.
Appreciate you stopping by like this on such short notice to talk to me.
Yes, sir.
Can I get you a nice cold glass of lemonade? When you made it fresh this evening. If you want, I could spice it up for you with a little bourbon.
No, thanks.
Myron?
Ray?
And my grandson. He's going to be starting at quarterback this year for Cutler.
I heard.
Yeah, I'm damn proud of him. I mean, he's worked long and hard for this opportunity. I mean, of course, I could have interceded on his behalf and gotten him under center a couple years early. His junior, maybe even his sophomore year. And I figured it'd be better for him as a man if he earned that opportunity himself, just like everybody else does under their own fruition. And he did, by God. But... Of course, as a result of that decision, you know, he has only this season, his senior year, to either make it or see his hopes and dreams shattered and broken right before his eyes. Are you following me on this, Ray?
Yeah. I follow.
You see, I'm not going to let anyone mar his chances to prove himself at an elite level to the scouts for college. Or even the pros, for that matter. You see, I'll stop at nothing to protect my grandson. And I will not let any obstacles or distractions get in his way. Not even this little distasteful matter that's come to our fair town.
Cammy.
Exactly. U.S. Congress. Or the FBI. I ain't gonna let none of them fuck with my golden boy. And you've been loyal, Ray. Damn loyal. But on this matter, I am gonna require a level of loyalty that you may find somewhat uncomfortable. Are you prepared for that?
I hope so.
Now, this girl, do you know how she came to be in possession of our product? I do not think she bought it.
shut up.
Don't tell me if you're responsible.
Well, he could have left when I said, but...
But by that stage, you threatened to rip his balls off, so what were we going to do?
I was just showing him I wasn't intimidated.
Right.
But you didn't have to escalate the situation, you know?
No, I didn't, but it made me feel
good. The fuck off with that.
You want to dance?
Vaughn, you're still bleeding.
Just shut up. Dance with me. Just dance. What's wrong?
There's no music. I mean...
Well, you need music. You need music. Oh, right. Sure there is.
Yeah. It's not very loud.
There's always something, isn't there? You fucking dance with me. Decompressed, you know. And we talked and drank coffee and wine, had sex a lot, danced naked on the porch. It's like we were in some kind of bubble. And all the shit in the world couldn't penetrate. And I felt real peace. Peace of mind, something. You know, the situation with Jenna was so horrible. Because of Jacob, really because of Jacob, and yet, despite all of that, there was this relief. And there was you. And then what did we do? We came back. Mm-hmm. I can't do this anymore, okay? I'm a liability. I know it. Don't listen to me. Let's go back. Let's go back to the mountain, huh? Where everything isn't so dark and complicated.
You know, it was so lovely.
Mm.
But, you know, real life is dark and complicated, and nobody... And nothing can fill that empty space inside you, but you.
I love you.
How can you say that?
You know how.
Just lay me down and kiss me to sleep. And if I'm going in the ground, never climb us down and to get hold of me. So just lay me down.
Sure they go back down again.
I'm dead tired, Trish. Hi.
No, you got something, Stewart. It worries me. Our babies only have one daddy now.
Arrested
or killed doing it. Can you do that for me?
If the desert didn't kill me, this town sure shit ain't. Besides, I got real good life insurance. Probably worth more dead than alive anyway.
Shut up, Ray. You're not indestructible.
Maybe I ain't.
Night last night. You might want to stay on this side of the county line from here on out.
Better get started.
Hey, you want some coffee?
Sure.
Some things you just can't find inside of the county line.
I'm not sure I know what to make of you. Hey, there's a guy from the Attorney General's office in there. U.S. Attorney General.
Bryce?
Hello, Vaughn. You look rough.
Vaughn?
Yes, sir?
What?
The congressman and the attorney general are close. I'm just here to watch from the sideline, make sure all the bases are covered.
Two different sports.
What?
Sidelines football. Bases baseball.
Good to see you, Vaughn.
Oh, it's great to see you too, Bryce. Really great.
All right, let's get started. Jordy? Since the other two Vicks were essentially executed in a cold, straightforward fashion, likely because they witnessed or were perceived to witness the King incident, I thought that we should focus on our local girl. First, the tox screen was positive for meth, as we figured it would be, and there were physiological signs she had been using for quite a while. The blow to the face, my guess, based on the severity of the socket fracture and the diameter of the bruising, is that she was hit with something hard. Metal, the butt of a handgun, a .45, not unlike the one you're wearing, Deputy.
What does that mean?
Only that Cammy's killer hit her with a gun like the ones that each of you are carrying, and then shot her and the other two Vicks with the same weapon. There were no signs of sexual assault, although she had had intercourse fairly recently.
Fluids?
No, he obviously wore a condom.
There's a surprise.
Why is that? Ray, you want to stay, keep your mouth shut.
I did, however, find some skin cells under her fingernails. We are running a DNA profile now. I also found evidence of sustained trauma to Cammy's buttocks. The inconsistent levels of bruising and redness and the evidence of healing in places suggest that these injuries were ongoing, sustained over a couple of months, and they were probably inflicted with a long wooden implement of some kind.
A paddle?
Yes, something just like that.
That's great work.
Thanks, Ray. This is bad for everybody. Bad, bad, bad.
Paddle marks don't prove anything. Except she got in trouble at school. A lot. Okay, so we got the guy?
You still here? No, we don't got the guy.
You're clearly still pissed. I can see that, okay? Just so you know, I've moved on.
Oh, you've moved on?
Yeah.
Bryce, congratulations.
Moved on from what, exactly?
I lost custody of my kid. What did you lose?
Jenna and I practically grew up together, Vaughn. You knew that.
Oh, is that why you told the court that I was a danger to him? Because you and Jenna go back, you both come from money? Give me that DC elite code of loyalty bullshit.
Okay, guys, can we do this another time?
You fucked up. You fucked up. Jenna was in the right. Do you still not get that? Hey, if you want to blame somebody, Vaughn, you blame yourself.
I do, every day.
Guys, we just got a 911 call I think you're going to want to hear about.
to small town Mississippi, where the sheriff's department is also putting out the fires. It's a miracle this place hasn't burned to the fucking ground. Now they send me this asshat from the attorney general's office. Out of all the people, it's like some kind of sick joke.
Okay, just keep it together, okay? Let's get through this and get back home, then maybe...
Maybe what? What, things will change?
Yeah, maybe they will. Maybe... I will. Maybe I'm ready.
You changed your mind after last night?
Yeah, or because of last night. Get in the fucking car.
I just went to the picket bag. I couldn't have been gone over 20 minutes. Oh, my Lord Jesus.
He's somebody who's pretty closely connected to the scene here.
I'm not seeing me.
Everything's wrong with this town scene.
What does the girl know?
Damn if I know.
He's in the back.
Wait.
What about Willie Joe?
What about him?
I mean, shouldn't we be over there?
We will be in a minute.
Cream on.
Deputy Everett.
You fellas, excuse me, I got a little legal matter in which to attend.
Kip on these fine Maduros, Ray? Just had them flown in from Honduras this morning.
No, thanks.
Yeah, suit yourself. Sit down.
We got a lot going on, so if we could just speed this along.
So then you don't want your money, then?
Yes, I do.
Well, then you be polite and you sit your ass down, Raymond.
Oh! What the fuck?
You been fucking my grandson's girlfriend? The dead one? Or shall I say the prematurely deceased underage one?
How'd you find out?
The Blackbird told me. Or told Myron, actually.
Willie Joe.
Yeah, Myron, he's a little scarier than you. Don't take it personal.
Myron killed Willie Joe, you motherfuckers.
No, I wouldn't say that at all. That did not happen.
God damn it, I was just over there, John.
Doing what?
Same meth we found on Cammy, I'm sure. What's the verdict, Jordy?
Well, I think technically we can rule this an overdose, except he has a couple broken ribs and a burn, maybe from a taser.
Maybe he saw something he wasn't supposed to see.
Is this kind of thing common around here, Sheriff?
Well, we do have a little bit of a drug issue here.
I'm not talking about the overdose.
You best be careful they don't try to pin this on you.
Why the fuck did you kill Willie Joe?
You better be careful about your words there, Raymond. For fear that others might want to turn that question around on you, such as why did you go there and try to intimidate him? And now we got to hear about this illicit secret affair you were having with Cammy King. I mean, this is scandalous, boy.
A lot of people had something going with Cammy.
Yeah, but you're the only one I didn't know about. You've been deceitful, Ray.
Look, I'm sorry.
You sure as hell are. Does your wife know you're an adulterer?
I was afraid to tell you, but you leave my family out of this.
You were afraid. You had every right to be. Only you didn't help your situation and by not telling me the whole truth. Now, did I not tell you that I needed your utmost loyalty in this matter, didn't I?
Yes, sir.
And did I not take him under my big old wing and save you when you got back in the desert? In that nasty-ass condition you were in. What? You didn't think that was doing a Sheriff Bowman, can you, did you? Did you?
No, sir.
You are going to make this up to my grandson and me, aren't you?
Yes, sir, I will.
Now, what conclusions have the FBI come to? Have they found out about Principal Markey's deviant sexual behavior yet?
You mean the pedal marks?
That's the least of it. Rumor is there were videos.
I ain't heard about that.
Even now you have. You see, this whole damn thing is an embarrassment to me. And this is what you're gonna do, Ray. You're gonna take Principal Mark, you're gonna ride on down in the hall, and you're gonna leave him there.
No. That's where I draw the line. You want something like that done, you get Myron to do it.
Myron is busy.
Not too busy to kill Willie Joe.
Myron did not kill Willie Joe. And you would be doing yourself and your family a great service if you never uttered those words or you would fight him again. Understood? Consider this your penance. Principal Markey's life. For the life of one of your children.
You don't kill children.
I'll do what I have to do, no more, no less, period. Are you angry, Ray? So am I. I'm angry and I'm scared. See, I'm afraid my grandson may have killed that girl, filthy strumpet slut that she was. But I am not going to allow that misstep to ruin his life. That boy's got a bright light of a future ahead of him, and not even the goddamn federal government is going to dim that light. Now you pick up that gun and you do what you're told. Don't forget your money. You earned it. You make it look like a suicide. But first we're going to need a confession. Either on video, written, whatever comes easier. And one more thing. Are you sure you won't have one of these in the door? They really are quite nice. They are black, bold, and delicious. Now get the hell out of my sight.
If the girl knows anything, she's not talking.
I'm starting to get the sense the sheriff's department knows something they're not telling us.
We still need to talk to Ken's parents. Cahill. Is this Agent DeSoto? Yes, sir, making progress. Oh, well, that's not exactly how it happened.
Just here to figure out what happened to your boyfriend. Now, I can see you cared about him. Can you help us?
He had a drug problem.
Seems pretty calm around here. Who beat him up? I'm in charge, not him.
Hey.
Jolene?
Shut up, deputy. Who beat him up, Jolene?
I don't know.
I think you do know, Jolene. And if you don't tell me right now, I'm going to haul your ass in for obstructing justice. Do you understand that? Do you understand what that means?
Ray, help me.
Ray. Ray. Why don't you take your best shot, city boy, but I'm gonna warn you. I might be a little more to handle that drunk son bitch you beat up in the bar last night.
This place stinks to high hell, and your ass is sitting on top of the dung heap, am I right?
No, sir, you are not. You don't know shit about this town, and you damn sure don't know fuck about me.
What is it you don't want to have to tell me?
Ray. Ray.
What is it, Ray?
Ray.
Hey. Vaughn.
Listen to me.
Can I talk to you? Cahill's not happy.
Right.
Hey. Hey, I'm right here. We're on a very short leash here, okay? There's a bright hot light shining down on Woody Road, and Cahill's feeling it. He's threatening to pull up a horse, so let's get this done, okay?
You mean he's threatening to pull me? It's not us, right?
Yeah. So you want to sit on this or go talk to the parents? Did Cammy ever talk about her personal life with you, her social or romantic relationships?
You judge her, don't you? I can see it in your eyes.
It's not my job to judge, Mrs. King. Just to find out who's to blame.
Who's to blame? None of us are blameless.
Hey, man.
Did you blaspheme in my home? With my daughter's body not yet in the ground? You are a godless man. I see no salvation for you.
You and me both.
Ma'am, did Cammy ever talk about Principal Markey?
Or maybe Tad Dawson.
Agents, I respect your position. But is it entirely necessary to do this now?
Godless.
You made your point, ma'am. But I'm actually here to find out who killed your daughter, whether or not you want to condemn me to eternal damnation, okay?
You think I'm slow because I believe in the Lord and seek his ways? Because I find comfort in knowing that my daughter only rests in Abraham's bosom because flesh was pierced and blood was shed at Calvary?
Mrs. King, were you aware of Cammy's drug problem?
Vaughn.
What? It's not a secret, not anymore.
Get out of my house.
Brought her to me. Never looked wild as on her. I went and got greedy. I think it's gonna cost me.
Cost you what?
I guess I thought I was owed something more than a paltry living because I fought no. And my family deserves something better. But I can't seem to see the reason in most anything now.
Mr. Vaughn. So did I, so did your granddaddy. That's what poor folks do. We do things that other people can't or won't. That don't make us better.
What don't? Firing a gun. Killing a man.
Most folks wouldn't get in a pen with an 800-pound animal that could kill him with a flick of his head or a stomp of his foot. A lot of folks think I'm stupid. There's all the broke bones I got, concussions. That's the beauty in it. There's a need, a hole that got to be filled. And that's the choice I made. Accept that risk, danger, for other people won't. You're a strong arm man, Ray, that's what you do. I can't blame you for using what little talent you got to make a better life for your family.
You don't know what I've stooped to.
I know John Dawson is a bad man.
I put my family at risk.
There are things you can do to change that, ain't there?
I don't know.
There better be. Those kids deserve better than you. You deserve better than me. But I did raise you to make your own choices. They say we grab a couple of those horses and go for a nice long ride like we used to when I was a kid.
I sure wish you could. Bye, Daddy.
So I know this is off topic. When you said you might be ready,
There are a lot of variables, Vaughn.
Variables like...
Oh, please, okay? We're not really going to buy a fucking cabin in the mountains and run a souvenir shop, are we?
Why not? Well, we can.
Hello? Really? Yeah. All right, well, we'll be right there.
What?
We gotta get back.
Mister showed up.
With a note from Cammy King.
Well, Cammy wasn't ever the best student. Apparently she had an arrangement whereby she could pass her classes.
And insurance, should he fail to make good on that arrangement.
Yeah, but do we even know that this note was written by Cammy?
If I had a handwriting sample, I could make a good guess.
Well, that should be easy enough to get. So we've got the guy. What are we waiting for? Still doesn't mean he killed her. I mean, it's obvious. No, the only thing that's obvious is you, Bryce. Why don't you take a step back? We got this, okay?
Okay, forgive me if I have some concerns about your ability to look at matters with a clear head.
What do you want to do?
Bring him in. It's way too easy. I am not asking, Vaughn. Look, we're not just talking about the death of your little trailer park girl here, remember? We're talking about the death of a congressman's daughter.
Do you honestly think that I make a distinction between the two? You asshole.
Look, Bryce, why don't we play this out for another 24 hours and see where we are?
There is a football game tonight.
Yeah. I want to talk to that quarterback again. I'm going with you. Oh, great.
I think Mr. John is funny looking.
Yeah, he's a little funny looking, but you know, we all get a little funny looking when we get older. Take it from here, okay? Mr. John asked me to tell you everything is set up for you.
If you ever get that close to my children again, I will end you. Understand me.
Everything is set up for you.
Hey, baby girl.
Hey, Daddy.
You okay?
What the hell is going on here?
Mr. Dawson, please.
The agent's just had a few more questions for Dad.
Yeah, that's what I heard.
Good news travels fast around here.
Yeah, Bo, I know you're aware of this. My grandson is but a mere child. Now, he is entitled to counsel if he's going to be interrogated.
Mr. Dawson, your grandson is 18, and he waived his right to counsel.
Well, how very noble of him.
Look, we just want to eliminate him as a suspect. We're just going to take a DNA sample.
No, sir. As his attorney, I will not allow that.
Oh, so you're his attorney now? I thought you were just his grandfather.
On this matter, I will act as both, sir.
John Dawson, yes? Bryce McDaniel? Bryce McDaniel, Attorney General's office. I think we have some mutual friends.
Well, la-da-da. For your sake, I hope that's true, sir.
Pardon me?
I'm just joshing with you, buddy. Yeah, that's a hell of a tie you got on, especially like that little clip. Y'all excuse me, but we're gone. I need to talk to you in private.
Of course.
Dad, you mind the coach?
Hey. Hey, where are you taking him? What the fuck is going on here?
Big John runs this town. Joke is that when he dies, he may see fit to will it back to the people.
I'm sorry, what?
Gonna fix this, right, Ray?
If I can.
No, you're gonna fix it. That man was in our kitchen with our baby.
I know.
always provided. You've been a decent father. We are all in this mess now. You put us there.
Sure did. Sure did. I sent that congressman's daughter down to the holler.
What?
Met him at Rainer's gas station. He's looking for somewhere to bed down for the night. Make out or something. Thought her and her pussy boyfriend should make the acquaintance of our local wildlife. Hell, I didn't know who they was. I was just being an asshole. Maybe. Maybe they reminded me of us. In that place, and this town was different. I don't know why I did it. Don't care neither.
Ray.
Saw Cammy King that night, too. Believe that. She sucked my cock. Something you don't ever do no more.
Uh-oh. Son of a bitch!
God damn it, woman!
Look on me. Did you kill that kid?
Hell no.
Well, then you better get your shit together and fix this. And you better pray that me and your babies are still here after you.
This is completely unacceptable. With all due respect, Sheriff, you are not in charge of this investigation.
Look, I am looking out for all of you here, for all parties involved.
What the hell does that mean?
What's the problem? We have enough for a warrant for the principal. Isn't that clear enough?
Are you that dense, Bryce? You don't see what's happening here?
Jesus Christ, Sarah.
Seriously, if the kid's not guilty, why is the DNA sample a problem?
We are both men of vast age in Killinger. But I think we both revel in the notion that it is our vices that will lead to our ultimate destruction. But do you know when a vice becomes a sin? When a man of vice raises his hands against the weak, undeserving party. I want you to think about that. I want you to think about that real well.
Jacob.
John is just making sure that everything is up to snuff, that's all.
Excuse me. What? We are the FBI.
You know, I don't think that means as much as you think down here.
What the fuck is this?
Agent Killinger, is it true that your weapon domestic abuse
policy
years ago?
Back up.
The charges were dropped. We're not here to talk about Agent Killinger's personal life. This is about finding out what happened to three innocent kids. But you're on probation for your actions, is that correct?
Leave me alone.
We have no further comments at this time.
Agent Killinger, do you have a history of alcohol abuse?
We have no further comments at this time. God! Mr. McDaniel. You represented Agent Killinger's wife in the legal proceedings that followed the incident, correct? Right? Yeah. No further comments at the monitoring work in this investigation.
We have no further comment at this time.
Smash the sun go down. Smash the sun go down. sun is burning. Someone else is down. So won't you smile and watch the sun go down? Smile, watch the sun go down. Smile, watch the sun roll down. The sun is burning. Someone else is down. So won't you smile, watch the sun go down?
Get some fucking clothes on. I need you to help me with something.
Who is it? It's Ray, we're kind of in the middle of something.
This is serious.
It's always the end of the fucking world with you, isn't it, Ray?
I wasn't talking to you, sugar tits. I'm trying to talk to my partner here, okay? And I'm not in the mood for any bullshit. Why don't you step outside so we can talk in private?
Fucker.
Well, that's what I do, yeah. Bomb fucks up again. I tell you about the time I was on maneuvers. Damn it, this man. Here it is. No slash. Big Daddy Dawson.
What, the killer?
Principal quarterback. Edward Scumbag son. Does it even matter? Does it even fucking matter? Fuck it.
Mom, nothing can change what happened, okay? You can drink yourself into a fucking oblivion, it'll still be there.
Will I get to see my son again? My time, occasional custody?
Probably in time, yeah.
Fuck off.
Fuck yourself.
Fuck off. Jen's never gonna let that happen. She's never gonna let me off the hook.
You don't know that.
Don't tell me what I fucking know, okay? I know what I fucking know, okay?
Calm down,
don't,
all right?
Don't.
Calm down
don't
and
do
listen
it.
To me.
Don't. Don't!
I'm not her. I'm not her. I will kick your ass for real. Stop feeling sorry for yourself, Vaughn.
Hey. I know y'all are going through some stuff, but I think my boyfriend's about to do something real stupid.
Tonight, we gather to celebrate our bright young athletes on the one hand, but on the other, we come together to mourn the loss of one of our own, Cammy King. Cammy was many things to many people, but most of all, she was loved, and she will be sorely missed. Brother Hedgepath will say a prayer for Cammy and the other young people lost in Wednesday night's senseless act of violence.
Please bow your heads and let us pray for God's mercy. We oftentimes do not understand why things happen as they do, Lord. But your wisdom, your infinite wisdom, is beyond the scope of our meager understanding. Your word tells us that
sir,
you love us.
I need to speak with you.
We
he
hear
says it's
that you love us in church.
Sadler, in the middle of the prayer.
We hear that you love us in prayer.
No shame.
I'm sorry,
we
sir.
Hear
the
that
race
you love
your grandson's welfare depends on you talking
yet
to him right now.
We ignore that love.
We are dying.
Hatred raises its head. Father, help us to take that love into our city, into our streets. We pray for your guidance, and we thank you for giving us the ability to love one another as we love ourselves. In the precious name of Jesus, amen.
Amen.
Go Bobcats!
Deputy?
Yeah. He's always rooking Lucas in on something. Most time it ain't good. Jordy, what do you got?
DNA's back.
Let's make this quick. I do not miss kickoff. Listen to me. You're not getting in the damn truck. I'm not getting in the damn truck.
I sure
about this way? Don't you go anywhere, son.
You better stop this madness, Ray.
I said, get the fucking...
kill you if I didn't love you so much.
Get to the hollow.
Get the sheriff to meet us there.
What, he confessed?
DNA had him dead to rights. Deputy from Jackson County, Kentucky. Well, former. He got pinched on a molestation charge, got fired, of course, and did 3 years. Then he started driving trucks.
What else is a registered sex offender to do?
People don't change, do they? He's just passing through, looking to score some crystal on a hooker.
And he found a feisty one.
She wasn't a hooker.
Really?
Really. Killed her and the other with his county issue 45.
But they didn't make him give it back? Oh, that's smart. Hey. Are we almost there? I'm gonna be sick. Okay. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Lovely. Great.
get out of the truck with that prick. Too bright, are you, Ray?
I...
Rain as hell on the passenger.
Welcome.
Sure you thought this through? Kill me, you ain't gonna get away with it.
Why not? You always do.
Long damn way from anywhere.
Maybe I need confession. Maybe I'm about suicide. Whatever happens to me, you will never throw my family again.
You're a coward, you fool.
Things I can do for you and your kin if you just stop this bullshit.
Shut up.
Better think about your kids, Ray.
That's what I am thinking about.
Be ashamed of them growing up without a daddy.
Oh, motherfucker!
Thank God you're here. He's gonna kill me.
Shut up, both of you. Put your hands up right fucking now. Deputy, put the gun down.
No! Not as long as he draws breath.
Gun down, or I will cut you down.
Sir, back up, Dad. I mean to do what I come to do, sir. My job, you need to.
Put the gun down, Deputy. Come on, get this.
God damn it, woman, shoot! Shoot! Now, hurry, okay?
I am so sorry. I'm so sorry.
Give me a ride back to the stadium so I can see my grandson fly.
He did. Grandson didn't do it. Maybe you should try talking to him sometime.
Thank you.
You getting some candy?
Yeah.
Still slow? I kind of like it that way.
You nervous yet?
No.
Really?
Well, maybe a little.
So you sure you want to pick him up in the patrol car?
Absolutely.
What time does this flight get in again?
Turn the light bar on.
Thank you.